The Drift by Sanford Lab, where our researchers answer your giant science questions in bite-sized videos. Submit your questions via direct message on Facebook, Instagram, and Twitter.
In particle physics, we want to understand the universe through its tiniest constituent, the elementary particles. And among the particles we discovered, neutrinos are weird. We know they exist, we know how they are generated in nature, we even know how to produce them ourselves, but truth is, neutrinos barely interact with matter.
Super shy guy, so annoying.
They can go through the entire Earth without being stopped. If a neutrino reaches us,
actually, every second, 100 million million neutrinos are going through your body. It's fine. They go through.
If a neutrino reaches us, chances are it may come from a part of the universe that is very far away.
Wouldn't it be cool if it could tell us how things are over there?
We try to understand how neutrinos behave. And turns out they're quite moody. They oscillate. This is as if that they are producing a given flavor, let's say an outfit, and they are, over time, changing flavor, like you change your outfit. Let me introduce you to the electron neutrino, the muon neutrino, and the tau neutrino.
Three different outfits.
We've seen in experiments this oscillation business, and a direct consequence of this fashion show is that for neutrinos to change flavor or outfit over time, they need to weigh something, a small number, but they need to weigh something different than zero. And in our model, the neutrinos are predicted to weigh absolutely nothing.
Problem.
Also, neutrinos could help us solve a big problem we have. Why we exist?
Yep.
Let's start at the beginning, the Big Bang. When the universe was created, there should have been, according to our understanding, an equal amount of matter particle and antimatter particles.
Each particle of matter has a mirror twin, its antiparticle. It's like you punch a hole in a piece of paper, you get a confetti and a hole.
Once matter and antimatter combine, party, they annihilate into pure energy. So theoretically, if we started with equal parts, everything should have annihilated and we should even not be there. Yet, we have a world of matter, all the galaxies, planets, everything you see around you, it's all matter. So there have to be some tiny surplus of matter over antimatter created at the start.
And we have no idea why.
Back to neutrinos. If neutrinos and antineutrinos oscillate in different ways, this could give us hints on this puzzling matter-antimatter asymmetry.
That is almost a century-old mystery in particle physics.
So, poking our neutrino friends, this tiny, tiny particle, could help us explain our entire universe.
As soon as you study neutrinos, whatever they dare to say, it's gonna be interesting.